So what's the role of finance in all of this? How do they help this agenda?
Finance and the private sector at large is critical for future development. I think this is central to the Sustainable Development Framework and the Sustainable Development Agenda. And I think ICRAF has pioneered some engagement with the private sector in your research. So I'd like you to say something about that.
If we look at the global economy, agriculture contributes 6% towards GDP and forestry just over 1.5%. It's a substantial contribution on two-thirds of the world's land area. We face three major objectives, and the first one is to make smallholder agriculture more profitable, because if we leave smallholders out of the value chain, they will continue to suffer and continue to use a lot of our natural resources and environment unsustainably. So how do we bring those smallholders into value chains in the marketplace? And that has got to be driving and pulling from the private sector as well. The examples that Peter referred to are trying to build the trust with private sector so that they can understand our perspective and our contribution towards working together in a close relationship. What CIFOR and ICRAF do is to help identify and manage risks in supply chains. And in doing that, provide technical expertise and a connection through to the livelihoods of those small farmers, and above and beyond just that financial reward. It is the multiple benefits of forests and trees.
I think we live in really interesting times, because on one side we have the private corporate sector to try and achieve more sustainable value chains. This is of course driven both by the consumers who demand this, but it's also fundamentally driven by an interest to do better on the ground. There's a lot to do on this. We had the New York Declaration on Forests a year and a half ago, where lots of private sector, civil society, and some governments and provincial governments committed to end deforestation as part of the value chains. That's a major political step forward. Now we're into the implementation of that.
So essentially, CIFOR and ICRAF face three challenges in dealing with the private sector. The first one are the misconceptions that the private sector have about research, about the role of public institutions and public investments. And there is a disconnect here, even though there is so much emphasis on public-private partnerships. And we're helping break down some of that disconnect. I think the second thing is we need to remember that the small-scale farmer is the private sector. They're the ones who take decisions, who have to look at how their own livelihoods are benefiting from engaging with the marketplace. Unfortunately, small-scale farmers often think about cash flow. And so long as the cash is coming in, they don't look at their profit and loss. And even though they have a positive cash flow, they may end up making a loss. And we've got to help bring a lot of those skills in engaging with farmers. And we're not going to reach them one at a time. It'll be through farmer groups, cooperatives, associations, interest groups, and rural platforms. And that is where engaging at scale with the private sector will really make a difference. The third one is from the investor's point of view, both the traditional ODA donors and also new financing instruments, because we are research and development organizations, publicly funded, and our role is to generate and validate and produce international public goods. But many people have this mindset that, well, if it's a public good, it must be a private bad. And if it's a private good, it must be a public bad. And we need to break down some of that to look at how we can better combine public goods with private interests.
We need also to find ways for the private finance sector to engage. And that's where the large, very large capital is available. There are trillions of dollars, literally, in equity in the world looking for good investments for sustainable development. This is a requirement from their stakeholders.